Praise the Lord. Makakita. Tiga eighty. Malay nilay. Tiawara. Talo palaba. Pakalulah hidlo patu. Greetings in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I warmheartedly welcome you, Halapua, Halapuo, and Lennox, Bronok, Lau, Taini, to this special day in your lives, the beginning of your lives together as new family. I also extend my warm welcome to the guests of both the bride and the groom who are here today to witness this special occasion. The marriage ceremony will be conducted both in English and in Tamil. Our first hymn is hymn Amazing Grace. We've got a choir here to sing with us, so let's sing together the first hymn Amazing Grace.
God, your generous love surrounds us, and everything we enjoy comes from you. In your great love, you have given us the gift of marriage. We ask you to bless Halapua and Lennox as they pledge their lives to each other, that their love may continue to grow and be the true reflection of your love for us all. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Is appointed by God. The Church believes that marriage is a gift of God and creation and a means of grace in which man and woman become one in heart, mind, and body. Marriage is the sacred and lifelong union of a man and a woman who give themselves to each other in love and trust. It signifies the mystery of the union between Christ and the church. Marriage is given that husband and wife may enrich and encourage each other in every part of their life together. Marriage is given that with delight and tenderness they may know each other and love, and through their physical union may strengthen the union in their lives. Marriage is a way of life which all people should honor. It is not to be entered into lightly or selfishly, but responsibly and in the love of God. It is for this that these two people have come to be joined. Therefore, if anyone knows any just cause why they may not be lawfully joined together, let him or her now speak, or else hereafter forever hold his or her peace. I urge you to remember that you will stand on Judgment Day, and everything that was hidden in the heart will be revealed. So if one of you knows something that should be a reason to stop you being married, I trust you tell me now. For if a marriage is not done according to God's words, then God is not with that marriage, and their union is not righteous. As you both shall live. Louder?
I do.
Wonderful. Now let's hear from Halapua. Halapua, hala for all. Do you take Lennox Brongo Lautaimi to be your wedded husband, to live together with him in the covenant of marriage? Do you promise to love and cherish him in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him for so long as you both shall live? We heard you. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Where?
Lennox and Halapua, this is a very, very important moment where you will say your vows to each other, and so I invite you, Lennox, to begin, and please say after me. I, Lennox Brongo Lautaimi, in the presence of God, take you, Halapua Hala for all, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, as long as we both shall live. This is my solemn vow to you. Okay, Halapua. I, Halapua Halafo'o, in the presence of God, take you, Lennox Bronco Lau Taimi, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, as long as we both shall live. This is my solemn vow to you. Right? It's the time for exchange of rings. Can I have the ring here, please? Let us pray. God of steadfast love, by your blessings, let these rings be to Halapua and Lennox a symbol of the vows which they have made this day. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Start with you, Lennox. You say after me, Halapua, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage and of the vows which we have made today. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Say after me, Halapua. Lennox, I receive this ring as a sign of our marriage and of the vows we have made today. Thank you. Right, let's continue on. Halapua. Lennox, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage and of the vows which we have made today. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Okay, Lennox, you say after me. Halapua, I receive this ring as a sign of our marriage, of the vows which we have made today. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Join hands again.
the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife. And the two shall become one. So they are no longer two, but one. Let no one separate those whom God has joined together. Before God and in the presence of us all, Halapua and Lennox have made their solemn vows. They have confirmed their marriage by joining of hands and by giving and receiving of rings in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. I therefore proclaim that they are now husbands and wife. May God the Son enrich you with his grace. May God the Holy Spirit strengthen you with joy. May the Lord bless you and keep you in eternity. Amen. We will continue on to the Holy Communion. I would invite three people from Halapua's family and three people from Lennox family, so that we will take Holy Communion. Okay, if we could have three from each family, or at least someone from both families to take Holy Communion.
I got a glass.
On the night of his betrayal, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup, and again giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Drink from this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as drink in remembrance of me." Lennox mo Halapua ko e sila I kalotu e ni ho'omo mari o fai ake sino hatau e ki. The body of Christ, which was given for you, keep you in eternal life. Take and eat in remembrance that he died for you, and fed on him in your hearts with thanksgiving. The blood of Christ keep you in eternal life. Take and drink in remembrance that it was poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins and feed on him in your hearts with thanksgiving. The body of Christ, which was given for you and I. As you receive it, take and eat in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts with thanksgiving. The blood of Christ keep you in eternal life. When you receive it, take and drink in remembrance that it was poured out for you and I, and for many, for the forgiveness of sins, and feed on him in your hearts with thanksgiving. As we listen to the words of God.
First Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 to 8. The affirmation. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It again. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails.
Amen. That's the best we can give you today. The word of love, God is love. That's the present and the cornerstone where your family is built today. God, Jesus, never wrongs, loves us from the beginning. He gave his only son in order to give us hope and to give us eternity. So love is the cornerstone of your family today. Amen. At the moment, we will continue on to signing of the marriage certificates. So we got the table on the other side. I would like to invite one from each of the family as a witness for today's wedding ceremony.
Thank you.
Makua. I give you the documents. First document. You keep it. And so I and Devita have the scriptures. Keep it and follow the word of God. I invite everyone, please rise. And we will sing the last hymn, The Lord's My Shepherd. We've got five verses. You've got the words in your program. And we've got also a choir who's going to sing with us today, The Lord's My Shepherd.